Hello and welcome back. This is Frost Air, and we are playing Empty the Show again. We're gonna give the Giants one more game of our best. Oh, we need to do some player. That's right. Send down Paul up Waldron. Send down. Meryl Kelly and Justine's. There, perfect. Because he fits right into the lineup. Got it. So now Waldron and Kelly should be vertically. Hopefully, have stamina to go from there. Heels weren't doing it yesterday. Kelly can go in Waldron. Still in rest, that's fine. Let's Schreiber back. It's fine. It's good. Breaks here. This is good. It's a good little the left extent, but that's fine. That's all sucking. Richard almost think never plays anymore. I'll probably get him in this song we got. Make sure that it's a point.
Welcome to the desert and inside Chase Field in Phoenix. An NL West matchup on the show. It's the San Francisco Giants and the Arizona Diamondbacks. Alongside my partner, Chris Singleton, I'm John Ciampi. Thanks for joining us here. And seeing the big bat in the lineup so far this year, Corbin Carroll. Always exciting to see him in action. Ready to go? Leading off, Austin Slater. That one is absolutely belted.
Yeah.
And that should be extra bases.
Yeah.
Around first, heading for two.
All right.
It's a double to start the game.
I don't think I'm doing anything
Everything
different
came
than
together normal. For him. Doubled into the gap, and that was a really nice swing to beat the inside pitch. Just beat him to the spot. Kept his hands tight inside that baseball, and that just allowed him to drive it into the alley right there.
So here's Wade now. Late with the swing there.
1-2.
Fights it off. He'll see another.
Some real good life going through the zone on that one.
And a 1-2. Got him swinging.
He came out of his mechanics there. Typically, he likes to shoot the ball the other way. But that time, a little anxious.
And now it's Wilmer Flores. And that's downed away.
Hitter's got some good opposite field power. What I like about something being hit to the right side into the outfield is that the base runner at second has a very good read and can determine whether or not he can score on that base hit.
No. Close one doesn't get the call. And the count's full. Outside, and that is ball four.
Now, this is a story we were paying attention to before the game. We've seen him give up walks in the past, and it's an issue once again early on.
Oh. And that's a fair ball coming home. He will score, and they take the lead. 1-0. Now the throw comes in. Runner holds at third.
That's like a good sound coming off the bat, man. And as he connected out front and lifted into the outfield, that's one of those swings where you just don't even feel the ball hit the barrel. That's poor stroke.
You're like, oh, we made the playoffs. It's fucking like
two on, one out. Swings, throw it, and that's a strikeout.
Jesus.
Well, that event seemed to be over as soon as it started. Three-pitch strikeout. You've got to be better at the plate right there. At least to foul something off, extend that at bat.
And a ball and two strikes. Got him. That ends the inning and stops things from getting out of hand. Two men. We go to the bottom of the first. This is Corbin Carroll. Chris, he's currently the team leader in OPS. Left field, way back there.
dives, but it falls. And now it looks like extra bases.
What was it?
Love how he let that ball travel, trusted his hands. Nice job of going the other way.
Ketel Marte up to the plate. Runner on the move. Pitch in for a strike. Throw to second. Tag. And they got him.
Wow. That goes to show you stealing a base is a tough thing to do and far from a sure thing, even with big-time speed. It's not easy to catch him, but that was a great catch and throw.
That one ripped. That's down. One hops off the wall.
And he'll pull into second safely. Throw is high and over his head. Not in time. He's safe.
What a great swing on that ball. Took the barrel right to it. Nice extension as well. 105 exit velocity. That tells you everything you need to know about that swing.
Hard hit left side.
Whips it to first. But the game is tied as the run comes in.
So important to really lock in on an at-bat like this. It seems easy with the infield back, but you've got to make sure you put the ball in play. Put it on the ground, let that run in.
That's good.
Two down, nobody on. That one not close. And that's ball two.
They've got him working a little harder in this first frame than he anticipated.
Swing and a miss. Struck him out. And that will back here at Chase Field, top of the second. And now it's going to be Blake Sable. There's the strike up high. And the count one and two. Runs it up to 96 to record the punch out. Now Marco Luciano. In the air, left side. Schwarber settles under it and puts the squeeze on that one. And there's two away. Nick Ahmed here to hit. Two outs. Gets a piece and stays alive. A wide to kick the pitch. And that one lifted in the air, center field. Carroll moves towards it. Makes the play, and it's out number three. We go to the bottom of the second.
Gotta know your guy.
Back here in the desert, bottom of the inning. Now it's the shortstop, Garrett Hampson. Slapped the other way, foul. The wind of the pitch. Swing and a ground ball up the middle. That's a base hit. So a man on base to start the inning. And now it's the polar bear, Pete Alonso. At the belt and fires. Runner takes off. Swing and a miss. Throw to second. Safe. Siggy, he definitely showed off the wheels there.
Yeah, and it turned out to be a bang-bang play. StatCast gives us the data, and that stolen base wasn't possible without that sprint speed.
And a swing and a miss down on strikes, and that's the first out. Here's Lourdes Gurriel Jr. Man at second. Up the middle, Ahmed. On to first, and two away now.
Not a bad outcome in that spot. The runner moves up to third, and now they have a chance to drive in the go-ahead run. It's not a knock, but at the end of the day, it's a good at-bat.
Stepping in, the long ball threat, Patrick Wisdom. The pitch. That one kicks away from the catcher. No advance, though.
He would have been out.
Swing and a miss as he was out front that time. Swung on, belted.
There we go.
That one's back. And forget it.
Really great job of anticipation there. He knows he throws the sinker. That one down in the zone. You're trying to beat it to the spot it's getting to. Well, he won.
Two outs, base is empty.
Oh, need that.
Swing and a miss. Struck him out. That is the inning. D-backs add a pair on the homer. And this is now a 3-1 ball game. Major League Baseball is on the show. And welcome back to the ballpark. Top half of the third inning. Austin Slater stands in. And that gets the inside corner for a strike.
Well, after putting up a nice inning on offense, got some runs across, this is where you look for the starter to go out there, have a shutdown inning. Don't give that other team any hope. You just hope that he can get through this inning, get the bats back up there while they're hot.
Swing and a fly ball in the air out towards right center field. It gets down, a base hit. So a runner aboard to start the inning. Here's Lamont Wade Jr. And the pitch. And another ball.
Well, these Giants showing great discipline at the plate, and patience definitely seems to be the name of their game in this one. He's only given up one run, but the starter's pitch count is starting to get up there, and that might be the best news yet for this offense.
This one in the dirt, and an excellent job keeping it right there. Out there to center. Carroll moving under it. Hauls it in for the out.
You know, sometimes all it takes is getting to the next arm before an offense does any damage, and that might be the case today.
And here's the first baseman, Wilmer Flores. That clips a corner. Up and in, 2-2. Well, Chris, through the early stages, he hasn't been very efficient in terms of the pitch count. He's going to need to get some quick outs if he's going to get deeper into this game. This one popped up. Foul ground, first base side. Makes the grab, and there's two gone.
That one didn't really get to five.
It is interesting, though, when you consider the way the game is run now, doesn't even matter that much if your starter doesn't go that deep because teams are really aggressively building their bullpens. Next pitch is outside.
Two balls, two strikes.
Packs and misses. It's a strikeout. One left for San Francisco, and it remains a 3-1 ball game. And we're back. Leading and off. Now, Corbin Carroll. Right-hander kicks deals. And that one is lifted in the air. Soler gets under it. Puts it away for the out.
Bullshit.
Maybe caught that one off the end just a little bit. Couldn't quite barrel it up enough to really drive it.
An outstanding hitter in Ketel Marte. And they'll do it again.
I just don't think he's going to get it. I think the game is against him. They're like, no, you can't. You can't break.
2-2 down. Knocks that one away, and we'll do it again. Wouldn't chase that time.
He should get a pretty good pitch to hit here with a three-hole hitter coming up if he's walked.
In the air, out towards right center. Soler gets under it. He's there. He's got it. Two away.
Up next to the diamond, the first baseman,
Christian Walker, the next to hit.
Walker.
Next offering is in for a strike.
Take it.
Outside.
Get out of here, Giants. Go back to San Francisco.
He swings and drives one out to deep left field. Get out of town.
For a pitcher, the odds are in your favor if you keep that breaking ball down. That time, he got punished for it. Hitter just did a really good job of staying within himself and getting the barrel to the baseball.
Two down, nobody on. Fouls it back with two strikes. Yeah.
three balls? Two balls. Should be a full count.
That one misses, and that's ball two. Eighth pitch of the at-bat coming up. This one grounded to Davis. And that is the third out of the inning.
Oh, wait,
but the solo shot stretches their lead even further. As we go to the top of the fourth, here's the third baseman, J.D. Davis. Fastball for a strike.
He's pitching well, but not throwing a ton of first pitch strikes. Usually doesn't work out for success, but you can never predict baseball.
Here's a 2-2. The punch out there. One away.
So I think he was waiting on the changeup right there, and he got it. It just drifted too far in on him. I think that pitch is just a little more out over the plate. Probably squares it up, but instead, he's going to have to go take a seat.
Blake Sable, the next Giant to hit. Swing and a miss as he was late that time.
1-2.
And the slider just misses. Got him licking. Giants go in order.
Impeccable command in that one. Three batters, three strikes.
Bottom four, and now the shortstop, Garrett Hampson. Hard hit, right side. Slings to first, one up, one down.
But
up next to the Diamondbacks, the designated hitter.
Here's Pete Alonso.
But.
And here it comes.
Up top right.
Ball two. Two balls, one strike.
Can you go up here?
All right,
I'm not making me go fishing.
There's a strike.
Now they're going up. Hold on, bud.
One down, base is empty. Chop back up the middle, and that chance handled. Tosses to first, two up, two down.
This is important. If he can go 1-2-3 here, will be a very positive sign for him and for his team.
Here's Gurriel.
Gurriel.
The pitch. There's a swing and a drive. Soler goes back. To the warning track, makes the catch. Back here at Chase Field, we go to the top of the fifth, and digging in for San Francisco, Marco Luciano. Trying to get him to chase on the changeup that time.
All these Giants looking to string together better at bats when they have runners on, but it just hasn't happened for them yet. They only have one hit with runners in scoring position, so a lot of squandered opportunities. It's tough because those are moments you just can't get back.
And there's ball four.
Well, he tried to nibble right there and just missed his spot. Hitter didn't offer at it. Now he has somebody to worry about over at first.
That one hammered, but pulled foul. The Giants trailing by three here in the second game of the series. That one hammered center field. Pulls it in on the warning track. Back to the top of the lineup, Austin Slater, the next Giant to hit. That one in there across the letters. Goes down looking.
Wow, that's a tough call for the hitter, but the pitcher will take that all day long. Not quite in the strike zone, but he found a spot that the umpire is going to at least for now, allow him to get that call. So hitters are going to have to make an adjustment, but pitchers are going to learn from those things and really try to exploit them if they can.
Breaking ball inside. The count now 2-2. The 2-2 gets a check swing. Now an appeal to third. No swing. Two outs. Swing and a miss, and he struck him out. He battled for a long time, but it finishes with a strikeout. You can't be mad at yourself after an at bat like that one.
He struck him out the first time.
Ready to go for the last half of the inning. Here's some real power at the plate. Patrick Wisdom. Next offering in there for a strike. And that is strike two.
Two strikes.
That'd be five. That's good.
That one lifted to left, and that'll fall for a base hit.
Nice.
And the leadoff man aboard.
Super slow.
So Bob Melvin, new pitcher on here, Mason Black.
Well, they didn't get much length out of their starter in this one, so they've got a lot of outs to eat up in that bullpen. I think they'll look for some length out of him right here if they can get it.
The 1-1. On the ground to first. Over to Luciano. Turns it. Double play. That's ideal relief
that's like
efficiency. One pitch, two outs. Not half bad. So back to the top of the Arizona lineup. Here's the Diamondbacks leadoff hitter, Corbin Carroll. And another ball.
Two balls, one strike.
Fouls one off, 2-2.
This guy's seen two changeups in a row. Could be a little vulnerable for a fastball right here.
The wind of the pitch. Back foot slider ties him up, struck him out. Back here in the desert, and now the first baseman, Wilmer Flores. Right down to shoot. That is strike two.
Well, set to throw pitch number 100. He needs a quick inning here if he's going to be able to make it through six complete.
He goes down looking. Jorge Soler up at the plate. Ball to strike. The pitch. And strike two. The Diamondbacks leading by three. And we're at the top half of the sixth. Ground ball up the middle. And that one handled. Jump throw. In there safely.
Oh, damn. I really wanted that one, too. That's crazy.
Now it's J.D. Davis. There you see how he's doing down the stretch with his August and September splits. And a base hit right there. Schwarber fires it in quickly. And they hold him at second. Maybe this is going to be the moment they start the comeback. So first and second with one man gone. Mike Yastrzemski up here. There's one. Double play. They can't seem to break through. Inning over. And welcome back to the ballpark. Well, we go bottom six. And now, Ketel Marte.
Okay.
And a 1-1. Finds its way through base hit. Man aboard on the leadoff single.
Seems like he got exactly what he was looking for right there. Smash that one through the infield for the knock. When it's hit that hard, it makes it very tough on the infielders to make any sort of play.
So, man aboard, Christian Walker will hit next. On the ground to third. Fires to second for one. On to first, double play.
As a former player, watching 5-4-3 double plays brings back some adrenaline. It's such an exciting play, and it's always a great reminder of baseball being such a team sport.
And there's a ball. Action in the pen down there. R.J. Davidovich getting ready to come in for Bob Melvin. Beck getting cranked up as well.
Probably going to sit Merrill.
Into center.
Yes, got it.
Yastrzemski makes the catch, inning over. And we're back. Top of inning number seven. And here's the catcher, Blake Sable. Torrey Lovello is out. Down, and he's going to make a move here. So out of the pen comes the right-hander, Kevin Ginkle.
Well, he's been excellent against left-handed hitters this year, and that's his first test. This looks like a good move to the pen in terms of the matchup.
Ooh, geez, this is nice.
The 1-2. 99 miles per hour to finish him off. Liner snagged it first.
That swing right there tells me he's seeing the ball pretty well. I know it didn't produce a hit, but he made solid contact, and that's all you're looking to do anytime you're at the plate.
And it's through for a hit. And that keeps the inning going. So the batting order turns over. Now it's the Giants leadoff hitter, Austin Slater. And a foul ball. And a pitch. Some heat there at 98 miles an hour. So the Giants leave one. And this is still a 4-1 ball game. Set for the last half of the seventh. Now at the plate, Garrett Hampson. And a swing and a miss.
One ball, two strikes.
Cuts and misses. It's a strikeout.
Oh, there's a small sigh of relief right there. I mean, just to keep that speed off the base pass, it's not just the pitcher. It's other guys that have to think about it. Your infielders have to think about that runner potentially stealing, but also be in position to make a play. As an outfielder, you're thinking about a base hit to the outfield. I got to get to it quickly to try to keep this guy from taking an extra base. So I think everyone just a little more relaxed that he didn't reach base.
Out. Tosses across to first. Two up, two down. Two outs, base is empty. Lourdes Gurriel Jr. stands in now for the Diamondbacks. Right-handed reliever. To third. And he picks it up in foul territory.
Throwing the ball well, and they need this scoreless inning in relief right here. Been doing a good job.
A swing and a miss. That retires the side. Back here in the desert, we go to the eighth. Now it's the DH, Lamont Wade Jr. Now on the mound for the Diamondbacks, Ryan Thompson.
And he's been hit pretty hard at times this year, so.
Oh, can't pick it up cleanly.
Hit the ball.
And he's going to make it to first, and we'll see how they score it.
God, so why are you walking, staying there looking at it? Oh, fuck you, Ryan Thompson.
He's a 1-2.
Got a double, but.
Swing and a miss, struck him out.
He's getting on base.
Now the Giants' four hitter, Jorge Soler. Right through there for a strike.
There's a run scoring opportunity. You definitely got to push something across because it's not going to get any easier. Get to.
Oh, now this one's high and deep. Way back there. On its way. Gone.
No, Boo, clearly some frustration out there on the mound right now. I mean, that ball was so close to going foul. Would have been a long strike, but instead, batter gets rewarded. Did a nice job of getting to the pitch and hitting it hard enough to get over the fence.
Throw to first is in time. Here comes Mike Yastrzemski to the plate. And another ball trying to hold a one-run lead, and we're in the top of the eighth. Right through there for a strike. Side, and that is ball four.
It's tough after falling behind a hitter, two balls and no strikes, but now at least he gets a fresh start against a new batter. But he needs to get back into the strike zone and start pitching with conviction.
Back foot slider struck him out. But two come across to score in the inning, courtesy of this two-run
conviction.
Bottom of the eighth, down the third baseman, Patrick Wisdom. Kicks and fires. And that is cut on and missed. And it's 1-2.
One ball.
Clearly he was sitting on a fastball right there. It just ended up out in front of the slider. Hey, you can't fault him for his commitment. Now he's just going to have to battle with two strikes.
Got him swinging. He chased the changeup. One down. Gabriel Moreno getting ready to hit. There's a 1-1.
Take a timeout. Jesus.
They tried to get him to chase on a slider down and away.
You get seawalled up. Fuck.
Now this is in the air down the line. And that drops foul.
You could see he was trying to stay back long enough to handle the off-speed pitch, but just a little tardy on the fastball.
Swing and a miss for the strikeout. Pulled the string on the changeup.
The center fielder, number
seven. So the lineup flips over. Corbin Carroll stands in now for the Diamondbacks. Next offering upstairs. Two down, nobody on. Here, the bottom half of the eighth inning. Next offering is in for a strike.
Hold down.
Outside, and that is ball four.
One of the things about that two-out walk, the base runner over at first base is going to have a very aggressive secondary lead. So a ball down the line or into the gap will produce a two-out RBI, and those are the best. That is if you are the offensive side of the run.
Roll there. Safe. Singy, the best way to catch this guy might be on replay.
Yeah, and sometimes it's the only way to catch him, Boo.
Runner on the go again. That's a laser face hit. They
close,
get some insurance as the runner scores from second. It's 5-3.
Ball does a great job of letting that runner steal second base, get into scoring position, come through with the base knock, you add a run.
Stepping in, Christian Walker. Base hit, left center field. Throw stops the lead runner at second. Two on and two out.
Two consecutive base hits for this team. Just a solid swing right there. Caught it out front and lifted into the outfield for the base hit. Those always feel great.
Kyle Schwarber comes up to hit here. Gets a piece there. We'll do it again. Marte over at second. Walker on at first with two down. Check on the runner. Marte back in on a dive. Double steal. Foul ball left side. He'll see another. The 1-2. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. And that'll keep more runs from coming in. Inning over. But the RBI single pushes across. Back here at Chase Field, we go to the ninth. Digging in, Marco Luciano. Swing and a foul straight back.
95, so it's like not as.
Kicks and deals. Way high. That's foul off to the right side. Keeps the AB going. And a swing and a miss. And a strikeout for the first out here in the ninth.
Well, that right there is what you want to see out of your closer. Come in and close the door, cancel any hope that that opponent has in making some type of comeback to the ball game. I'll tell you what, that helps him settle in, and that helps everybody else relax a little bit to get these other two outs.
Base is empty, one away. You're at the top of the ninth. Fair ball. Around first and hustling for second. In safely. It's a double and his second hit. Here's the left fielder, Austin Slater. Yeah, the 2-1 hammered but foul.
All season long, he's racked up a number of saves, and sometimes the adrenaline doesn't get high enough until there's a runner or two on base.
Gurriel handles the chance.
Just about gives his skipper a heart attack, but that's where he functions best.
So they're down to their final out. Lamont Wade Jr. now at the plate. Tying run at the plate. That one fouled off. 2-2. Seawall is just one strike away. Got him! And that's the ball game.
I don't care if you're a top team or you're a middle-of-the-pack team. Every ball club wants to be dominant at home. Winning a game like this just helps to boost the confidence and makes you look forward to coming out again for the next one.
A 5-3 final score in this one.
That's good. Good stuff. Six innings of one run ball. Tops almost really good for us. Advance today. Oh, the Aces lost the playoffs.
That'll be it, I think. That will be two games for the Z. I don't think you guys so much for watching. I appreciate it. I will see you all next time.